Hi, welcome to the WTAMU Virtual Math Lab. This video will step you through College Algebra Tutorial 7, Example 17. In this example, we want to factor the binomial y to the 4th power minus 16. What is the first thing that we always check for when we factor? The greatest common factor. In this case, there is not one. Next, we want to check out the binomial. It looks like y to the 4th minus 16 fits the form of a difference of two squares. A reminder that we can factor the difference of two squares as the product of the sum and difference of the bases that are being squared. For example, if we had x squared minus a squared, it would factor as x plus a times x minus a. We can rewrite our binomial in this form. We can rewrite y to the 4th as a base of y squared being squared minus, and rewrite 16 as a base of 4 being squared. We can factor this as a product of the sum and difference of our bases of y squared and 4 and get y squared plus 4 times y squared minus 4. Next, we want to assess to see if there's anything else that we can factor. Note how the second binomial is another difference of two squares. That means we have to continue factoring this problem. Keeping the first binomial the same, we have y squared plus 4, and we can rewrite the second binomial as a base of y being squared minus a base of 2 being squared. The first binomial will remain y squared plus 4, and we can factor the second binomial as a product of the sum and difference of our bases of y and 2 and get y plus 2 times y minus 2. Note that the sum of two squares does not factor, so this is factored completely and is our final answer. Note that we can always double check ourselves on factoring problems by multiplying out the factors that we have. If they multiply to be the original polynomial, then we have the right factors. If they don't, we need to go back and try factoring the problem again. Note that if we multiplied this out, we would get the original binomial.